Welcome to our video review of Lime Chronicle. This is a 2D adventure platformer developed by an independent studio named Pixelica. Please keep in mind that this game is in early access, and from the time of this recording, we've played through version 0.9.13. As a result, anything you see in this video can be subject to change. Let's begin with the story. Lime Chronicles opens up with a few animated images and some text. You are Luca, a brave young boy who has been teleported far away into the wilderness by a dear friend and princess, amidst an outbreak on the kingdom overwhelmed by darkness and creatures. And with you carrying a powerful object, which could turn the tide, the Lamp of Light. So far, as much as the narrative seems like a typical bedtime story about light and darkness, it is a neat little carrot to draw the player into the world. This also applies to the main character, Luca, who isn't given a lot of backstory. This becomes more a vessel for players to immerse themselves in. Unfortunately, in the current build of the game, exposition is limited, and you are only drip-fed small bits and pieces of what is going on by characters you stumble upon throughout the journey. This will of course ultimately end with an end screen of the developers letting you know there's more to come. The game looks gorgeous with its watercolor art style, right down from its chibi-looking characters to the vast backgrounds that help bring the world to life. It seems to stick with this cute theme that you shouldn't underestimate. You might come across what looks to be a friendly troll, only to take a giant log to the face should you get too close. There is a good variety of enemies and locations. You will face various creatures as you travel through caverns, forests, and ruined cities. However, some of the animations suffer a bit at the moment, with some attacks being instant and not telegraphed properly. The journey begins not far from the game's hub town, and from there, the world opens up in a non-linear fashion and you are free to navigate through each area in whatever order you stumble upon. Within long, you'll realize that the world can be punishing, and if you want to make it far enough, you'll need to find and repair lampas. These serve as save points and a way to regain health and mana, or in this game's case, Luna. The way you go about doing that is by finding mechanical parts scattered throughout the world or being lucky enough to have them drop from enemies. This encourages exploration but also creates a risk or reward system, since you want to find the parts but also not die and respawn at the previous lamp many areas away from your location. However, this becomes less of an issue later in the game due to there being plenty of parts to be found or even bought. There are also wells which function as fast travel points, which make traveling between discovered areas easier. And to get your bearings, each area has a red orb you can destroy, which fill out in the game map to give you a better perspective. As you explore, you will encounter various different things. On occasion, you will meet other NPCs and their purpose isn't always obvious. Some might provide extra bits of dialogue, others might need your help, and others might provide help by selling your weapons, magic, or items alike. Regardless, it is a world that keeps you on your toes and requires at least some measure of focus. Monster and environmental traps that can catch you off guard, few stone walls are breakable, hiding treasure or swords. Also pits that will lock you in with giant nasty beasties. Did we mention you can find and befriend animals and have them tag along? Combat is a big aspect of the game, but also happens to be one of the weaker ones. You've got your swords and magic, each one being very basic. The swords are purely cosmetic and relies on statistics rather than having their own moveset. It is possible to upgrade the amount of combos you can pull off by spending pages you've acquired in the world. But still, they are all very much identical. Magic is a bit more interesting since they work in different ways. Throughout, you will collect gems in which you can slot into your lamp, though you're limited to only 2 active and 2 passive abilities at once. One of the earlier active abilities have you throwing a fireball, while one of the later ones, which we won't spoil, becomes much more enjoyable to use. When combat starts, you can notice a few issues. Some of the enemy's hitboxes seem larger than their actual model, causing you to take unintentional damage upon collision. Fortunately, the latest patch have extended the range of the swords to minimize the problem. Later on in the game, you will come across enemies that shoots projectiles at you from off-screen or even through platforms, which can definitely test your patience. Though one thing we never got tired of was watching items burst out of dying enemies, that is, if they didn't happen to get stuck in the terrain. It is possible to pick up ingredients, some of them used to craft food and other to enhance weapons. However, the developer have stated that this system have yet to be implemented and therefore encourage you to sell the ingredients instead. The sound design is for the most part good. It is always thrilling to listen to your sword make melee contact with whatever unfortunate soul happens to be in your path, even if that soul might be made up of solid material. The pouring rain in the forest areas helps make up a chilling atmosphere, as well as the unnerving giant storm of a boss approaching, or certain holes that warn you for an incoming attack. And as we mentioned before, nothing quite beats hearing that pop sound of items showering in your face after a kill. Some more distinct enemy noises would have been appreciated though. For those of you who would have wanted voice acting, might be a little disappointed as there is none. The music is incredible, right from the shooting menu theme that made us hesitate to press the start button. To the melancholy piano in the forest areas, and more uplifting adventurous track later on. We did encounter a few tracks that didn't loop properly. Overall, Lamb Chronicle doesn't bring much new into the 2D space and the combat could use more depth and polishing. That said, it is still an enjoyable little 12-hour title, even in its early access state, which can offer both a zen-like experience with its stunning backdrops and music, and an exhilarating rush as you try to make it to the next save point. The game is available on Steam for 12.49 euros or your regional equivalent. If you enjoy our video, please don't hesitate to mash that like button and consider subscribing to our channel so you won't miss any of the future updates. I'll see you on the next video and happy gaming!